The stamp of the Clemson Tigers is on bodies all over the ACC. Rick Barnes' team combines raw muscle, power, and accuracy. But today, the Tigers enter a den where hope is slim. Mike Krzyzewski's second-ranked Blue Devils are poised to jump back to number one. Duke is on a roll because of awesome D. Get ready to bring it on. Welcome, everybody, to Payne Weber College Basketball. We're at the Cameron Indoor Stadium, where the Duke Blue Devils are poised to jump back to number one, but they've got to handle a very tough Clemson team. Welcome, everybody. I'm Brett Musburger, along with Dick. Wait a minute. The Cameron Crazies have kidnapped my partner. They've got to bring him back because this is the biggest game of the season so far. As far as the Blue Devils are concerned, the Crazies have been on holiday since early December, and they are coming back, and they are going to deliver Dickie B in time for this game. Come on down here, partner. What about this Blue Devil team this year, Dick?
I'll tell you, Brent, they want to be number one, and they got a great chance with a win here today with North Carolina getting beat. But they'll have a tough task here. Darrell McIntyre, if he's healthy and he plays, they are a tough team, Clemson, and Buckner can play. And I'll tell you what, the Cameron Crazies are ready. They've been on vacation. I know you're ready, buddy.
Dick, when we come back, we're going to join John Saunders in our Wide World of Sports studios. What a day.
Basketball on ABC and Raycom Sports. Brought to you by Payne Weber. When you invest with Payne Weber, you invest with more intelligence. Gateway 2000, direct personal computers. Toyota, every day belongs to you. Make it count. Toyota, every day. And State Farm Insurance, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
The Toyota starting five for the Clemson Tigers, who come in here with a record of 11-5. Greg Buckner is their leading scorer, 17 points a game. Johnny Miller opens at the point instead of Terrell McIntyre, still nursing an injured foot. For the Duke Blue Devils, Rashawn McLeod in the ACC has picked up his scoring, averaging 15 a game, only two seniors, Wojo, Steve Wojciechowski. And of course, the Crazies are back from a holiday with a lot of energy. Already on their feet and beginning to bounce. It'll be Frank Scagliata, Steve Gordon, and Larry Rose are our officials. And we are underway in the Cameron Indoor Stadium. The Tigers control attack.
Hey, Brent, they've beaten them four out of six times, Clemson, because they're very physical and they're also a very deep basketball team.
That was Miller. Gets it back now. Remember, he's operating at the point. We will see McIntyre early. They feel out the defense and a great move coming down. Tony Christie with that wristband for the game's first field goal.
Well, Christie's having a heck of a year. His first two games, he's really struggled. The game clock has not started. The game clock did not start. There's the 20 posted up there. Christie, though, has this year really improved, shooting 47% as the Coach K and Quinn Snyder.
Special guest right there behind him, Alex Rodriguez, pretty good shortstop. You can see him there with his hand up to his face from the Seattle Mariners. He calls my friend Dickie B. One of the things he always wanted to do was come to the Cameron. And have you taken care of him this weekend?
I'll tell you, he's had a blast. We've had so much fun, you and I and all of us at dinner. There's Alex sitting with Elton Brand. He's like a little kid. He's a beautiful person, and what an unbelievable future he has.
How'd you like to be his agent,
buddy? Oh, 22 years of age.
There's Rick Barnes, done a fine job. One of the reasons why they match up against Duke, Dick was explaining to me, a lot of muscle and a lot of depth.
They really are a very deep basketball team, and they obviously become a better team when Terrell McIntyre. There's been a clock problem here. They're trying now to settle it. Clock did not start. There's a look at Barnes. Barnes has done a great job in his tenure. He's done a phenomenal job. In fact, this year, preseason, they were top five in America.
So they're going to start it at 1942.
They're trying to get a little look right here. There's Terrell McIntyre popping his head out. He's the engine that makes him go. It's like having a beautiful Rolls Royce, and when you don't have him on a floor, they struggle. How badly? Against Florida State, They outscore him in 25 minutes. He plays 68-33. He doesn't play. They get beat 32-19.
Langdon puts it over the point man. Here's Wojo on the penetration. Pulls it, sends it back outside the arc now. And for the free throw line, a whistle prior to that shot. That was Langdon squeezing the trigger on the shot.
Great free throw shooter. And I'll tell you about Trajan Langdon. He's been struggling right now, not shooting the ball anywhere near what he's capable of. I think you're going to see Langdon break out today. He looked so impressive in the workout earlier.
That foul against the big man, Greg Buckner, number one for the Tigers. They bring it back outside the horn. And here's the senior point man. He'll be the key man down the stretch for the Blue Devils. Missing from the perimeter. Rebound, Clemson. One shot and out now for the Blue Devils.
One thing against Duke, you can't let them knock you out early. They've been knocking everybody out early. Their margin of leading at the half is plus 20, Brent.
Barnes knows that. Miller carefully puts it back. Penetrating move, and Buckner offense. That's two fouls on Buckner. That's huge in this game.
That is really big, partner. No doubt about it. He's one of the most complete players in the ACC. At 30 against North Carolina. He's an inside-outside player, and I believe he's the best post player for a guard in the conference.
What a way to start off in the camp. Have your leading scorer get nailed. There, of course, is what they told you about. The earlier whistle. And no shot, no basket on it.
Well, what makes Duke so...
Traveling is the call against the Blue Devils, so they turn it over now, and Clemson will take it out of bounds, and here comes the pressure.
Now here comes McIntyre on the floor. They need this little guy to handle the pressure. He's an excellent ball handler. You're going to really love him, Brent. Buckner goes out, a little disappointed. This little guy can really handle. He's had a foot injury, injured it against Illinois in a loss on the road.
See him switch hands with the dribble and quickly get it up on Wojo. Now he's been trying to penetrate, lost the dribble, turned it on over. Carwell comes
give
back.
It up.
Give it up. Put it back now. And the foul is called on the shot as McLeod went for the field goal. He was fouled.
I'll tell you one thing about Clemson. They'll play very physical. They'll play aggressive basketball. Wojciechowski is the heart and soul of this team. He's the leader and makes it happen. He's such a contagious. His performance has become so contagious to everyone. Now look at him right here defensively. Volume man. There he is now playing the ball really tough. McIntyre bobbles it. They really make things happen off the turnover.
Dick, we're going to have a tough defensive game. 18-33, we've only had one field goal in the game. Duke looking for its first points. McLeod will try to give it to him at the free throw line. Free throw is going to be important if this is going to be a tough defensive struggle.
Well, you know, Duke leads third right now, leads the conference in scoring, is third in the nation. Number one is Billy Tubbs's unbelievable arsenal down there at TCU. They're number one, but Duke's better than 90 a game because they're so explosive from the defensive end to the offensive end.
2-1 and another whistle in underneath the glass that time. Clemson going for the rebound, and the foul is called against Duke. And Mike Krzyzewski's not happy.
I tell you, what a clinic.
He didn't like that call at all, and he has given the ref an earful. Domzalski's first personal of the game, 18-29 now, and the Tigers will bring it up.
What a clinic he put on in practice yesterday. Very impressive, Mike Krzyzewski, covering every facet of the game.
They leave Miller out there. Turnaround jump miss, but an offensive rebound by Weidman. And another whistle.
They're trying to call it quick early. They know this game can get very physical, and the officials are trying to set the tone right out of the gate.
Wojo has assessed that personal, and you can see number 32, Jamison, Harold Jamison, a 6'8 junior out of Vance, South Carolina, comes in, and Johnny Miller, the junior from Coatesville, Pennsylvania, who drew a start, will sit down.
I'll tell you, Jamison gives him a presence on the inside, a great body.
Christie and a rejection by McLeod. And Chappelle is fouled by Weidman in the backcourt. That's his second personal.
I tell you, a great block by McLeod, who's having a heck of a year. Rashawn McLeod, the first transfer ever to play at Duke, out of St. John's. There he is rotating over. He says, get it out of here, baby. I tell you, McLeod was sensational against Florida State. There he is. Inside, outside, had 25, a career high. When they were on the ropes against Florida State, he made all the big plays.
Now the Blue Devils will try to seize the lead for the first time here today.
Langdon had his career high last year, 34 against Clemson.
Got to defend them at the perimeter. They'll light you up outside if you don't.
You're right, Brent. You got to contain. That's one of the assets that you have to possess, and they have that, Clemson. Try to shut down that three-point shooting attack.
Keeping them out with seven on the shot clock. Finally, the three is there.
Mr. Langdon, where has your jump shot been? Shooting in the 30s from three-point range. He's too good a shooter for that.
first Duke lead.
He's second all time in terms of field goal percentage.
Former baseball player, loves having Alex here. Gonna try to put on a show for him.
Yeah, I'll tell you one thing. He and Alex were talking. He didn't like seeing a curveball.
Traveling, turn it over.
Wojciechowski, look at the eyes are up all the time. He is a typical point guard. He wants to run the club. He's extension. There's the little handoff. Langdon finishes it off.
Since their early field goal, Clemson has not scored. Remember, they jumped out to that 2-0 lead. Then we had the clock stoppage of play, and now it is 4-2, 17-19 here in the first half. John Saunders coming your way at halftime. He'll update you on everything that's going on. Busy day at college. Chappelle, good shooter and improving basketball player. Mike Chappelle, only a sophomore, 6'8". Remember that name.
He's getting better and better. He's got that great body for the next level. He's very smooth, and he can shoot the rock.
Iturbe was coming down. Iker Iturbe, he's out of Spain.
Great passer, tremendous passer. He broke the Kentucky press last year in the opening game when they beat Kentucky at Rick Pitino's club, and he did a tremendous job attacking the press. Hey, you know, you mentioned Chappelle. You and I were talking yesterday at the shoot-around how much we really liked him. He's shooting, Brent, 51% from three-point range.
I think he's got that NBA-type body as he develops good size. Iturbe misses at the free-throw line. Barnes watching, knows how important it is. Now he's down 4.62 in the early going. You can get put out of your misery in a hurry against this team and the camera. You have got to hang tough early.
Well, especially you don't want to go down 20 plus at halftime like everybody basically's been. The closest the team's been at halftime has been Missouri. They were down 9.
Carawell yanked away the second miss at the line for Iturbe. And now the Blue Devils will set it up. Cloud maneuvering, tries to get his man in the air, now comes over the top, misses.
Tried to get a little isolation, 1-on-1 for Rashawn McCloud. Comes out of St. Anthony's in Jersey City.
Wooney yanked that rebound down. He's a sophomore on the Ivory Coast in Africa. Look it back inside, and charging is the foul against Jamison. He picks up the personal.
We're going to take a McCloud, look right here. He's got him in a little isolation. Now he's going to work on a little reverse. The spin, there's the head fake. Now he's trying to get free by ball fake and head fake. Gets the little jumper off. They were all falling down for him against Maryland and against Florida State. He practiced that yesterday. Worked out on it.
Clemson extending that defense, picking him up high, but they still trail at 6-2. Wojo cannot penetrate down that line. Shot blocked beautifully. That was Witt who did it, and now the Tigers will come back down.
I'll tell you, they bring guys off the bench like Jamison and Witt who can flat out play.
McIntyre's open. Left-handed Jay is off the front of the iron, and another personal underneath. That's going to go against Jamison, and he has picked up two quick ones. We're going to take a break here. 15:59 to go. The Blue Devils poised to climb to number one, lead Clemson 6-2. Timeout. Dick, I know what your wife is going to be watching. Lorraine will be taking a look at the European Figure Skating Championships coming up. Michelle Kwan, Tara Lipinski, Nicole Bobic, that clean sweep for the Americans. We'll find out who they'll compete against in Japan. That's today at 4:30 Eastern here on ABC.
I'll tell you one thing, Brent. I watched you doing it. I love Michelle Kwan. She can flat out do it. She's a 10. There's no doubt about it. She was great. You guys did a great job. Leslie Visser and company. Dick Button. I mean, does he know his skating?
I'd say.
That's a little traveling right there. No, 5 seconds. Got a five-second call.
5 seconds against Carawell. We got to do away with that call, Dick. That's just another judgment call on the part of the officials. I thought it was going to work out, but I'm seeing
it. I like it.
I know you do. I know you've been campaigning for it.
I don't like the alternate position.
I don't like too many judgments. You don't. All right, back attack. Gives it up now and drops it into Buckner's hands. They need to get Buckner going. Clemson scored at 19:42. They're scoreless since then.
I'll tell you one thing there. Carawell now playing. He's like a glove playing Buckner. We could go inside, outside. He and McIntyre really are a great combination.
Great Duke defense. Finally give up the J to Witt.
I'll tell you, Witt has star potential. He had 17 and played brilliantly against South Carolina in that emotional rivalry when they had to play without Terrell McIntyre, and they got the big win at home.
Joe moves it over to the left side to Carawell, number 23, double team, pulls the trigger. I'll tell you, Clemson doing a good job of sealing off that glass, Dick. There's an awful lot of orange underneath the rim when Duke shoots. They're not giving them offensive rebounds at that end.
I'll tell you one thing, they can really block out and really get after you physically. You're right, partner, and I'll tell you something else. They're not backing down defensively. They're not intimidated at all. They have beaten Duke four of the last six times they've played.
Now, here comes somebody who's going to change things up as Wojo sits down. William Avery.
I love him.
When you watch him, he's number five. He's a freshman out of Augusta, Georgia. There's the point man of the future. He must develop this year behind Wojo for the Devils to make a big time run, and they love what he's done. He'll give you a little more quickness. They're hoping he can penetrate down that free throw line and bring it on.
Look at what the Duke's freshmen have done. Unbelievable. And remember this, they're missing Elton Brand, probably the best center in the ACC when he went down. Their leading scorer and rebounder out with that broken foot. He's sitting next to Alex today.
Nothing coming easy for the Devils. Clemson misses again, but yanked back down by Looney. Looney give it up.
Looney with that turnover. Hey, Clemson went to the Sweet 16 last year, and many of these kids have returned. There's Avery.
Chris Burgess with the rebound. Avery into the game, misses his first shot. That would have ignited the crowd. There's your offensive rebound. Put back misses, though, and Clemson controls it. Good save by Weidman. Clemson get an easy one. McIntyre's going to try to give it up on the inside, and the whistle. He did penetrate that time and put it into Buckner's hands.
Well, he's got great penetration ability. He's got super speed. He breaks the defensive player now with a lot of change of direction, a lot of shake and bake. Here he goes, the little guy. Look at his quickness. Now watch him change of direction. There he is, the little left-hander. Gets in the lane, dumps it to his buddy. He's the 3D man. He drives, draws, and dishes the rock.
Ricky Price with that personal dick. It is 6-4. Duke leads by two, 14-18 now.
They're trying to get Price some minutes. He came back, gained his eligibility the end of December.
Knocked away from McIntyre and hit last by the Clemson player. So that is turnover number six for the Tigers against this Duke D.
I'll tell you, they forced 23 turnovers, Duke, and 12 steals a game. And Rick Barnes knows he has to be concerned about that because Duke usually scores off the turnover.
Nick, let's see how Avery sets the table. Slowly brings the dribble up to the top now.
He's a combination guard, Brent. He can play either the point or the second guard slot.
Price in trouble. And a personal call.
No doubt about it. I mean, that was a tackle. That was an unbelievable tackle. I mean, he knocked him to the deck. And this is not Monday Night Football. This is basketball. Come on, Johnson. This is not football.
So they'll be shooting after the personal is called. McIntyre will sit down, and you wonder how the foot is holding up. Carwell also takes a break at the other end.
Well, they said his foot is certainly not 100%. It's about 85-90 right now. Rick Price, remember last year, Brent, he had a spurt where about seven or eight games in the ACC, he was the best sixth man in all of college basketball.
Allen's back, the seven-foot freshman there. You can see number 55. He picked up the personal foul that time.
I think Allen's back's got a heck of a future, and they've had some big players down at Clemson that have been very good. Guys like, you remember Larry Nance and certainly Horace Grant, and you got to talk about Dale Davis and Elgin Campbell.
Price makes it 8-4, double up on the floor, 13-54. Low scoring, tough defensive game. Pressure in the backcourt from the Devils.
Okay, right now, the tempo really is the way Clemson would like this tempo to be. I mean, down four after 7 minutes on the clock and not really playing exceptionally well offensively.
Miller being hounded. Burgess gives it up. Buckner against the shot clock, penetrates, blocked. Burgess, the freshman, with a fine rejection.
I really like him. His dad is here today. Kenny Burgess from out of California. Give it to him.
Avery nails the trifecta.
He said, forget about getting it inside. I'm going to let the three go, baby. He knocked down four off the bench against Arizona in the Maui Classic Championship.
He's giving him a little lift. It's 11-4. He just changes the tempo when he's out there.
Scored 21 against Arizona. Not bad for a diaper dandy.
Clemson needs to find a way to get number 21 more into that scoring column. They cannot give him shots. They are hounding Buckner. They finally get it back in his hands. One foot inside, over to the right side, outside the arc. Whistle before the shot. Price.
I'll tell you, Brent, you don't get easy shots against Duke. You're always harassed. There's constant harassment. Take a look right here at fast speed. I mean, do they get after you defensively? Always between you and the basket. Always giving help to one another, cutting off driving lanes. And then they got the big fellas inside who can reject, like Burgess and Domsalski and McLeod.
I tell you, Dick, I know you know that when teams play good defense, they are well-coached basketball teams.
Oh, no doubt about it. You got to really work in all the top clubs in America. That's one of the instance, one of the staples is the fact that they do play solid team defense. And there's a difference between individual defense and team defense.
Look at that, team D. Force another turnover. That's number seven.
It's like
that's a fine point guard who lost it.
You know, that's like poetry of motion. Every guy has to rotate together, get into driving lanes, give help to one another, communicate with each other. It's just not one guy playing the ball.
Tigers double-team the shooter that time and give up an offensive rebound and a putback for the Devils. Number 31, Shane Battier, the 6'8 freshman from Birmingham, Michigan.
He's their leading rebounder and leading scorer coming off the bench. Could you believe that? He was Mr. Everything in high school basketball on a Detroit Country Day. The same school that produced C-Web, Mr. Weber.
Wood has to give it up. Allen's back, the freshman, short, off iron, can't run it down. Price scrambles. Now let's watch the Blue Devils. They are slowly pulling away here, 13-4.
They really make you pay with that bench. What a screen by Burks.
Avery down that line. And a foul called against the Tigers.
Did I tell you yesterday how much I liked Avery? I really love him. He's just an old school backcourt player. He can play either guard slot. There he is, under control all the time. Little shake, nice little stutter move to get free. And there he is with the baseline power layup.
Dick, I don't know how they're going to do in the tournament this year, Duke, but I want no part of this team next year. Oh, you talk about a future. Oh, my.
Well, they get Elton Brand next year. They get Nate James, and they signed a kid from Fenwick, Illinois, who went to Michael Jordan's camp down there in Santa Barbara and played a little with Michael by the name of Corey Maggette, who everybody says is a big-time talent.
Here's Avery.
I think this year, though, Brent, there's no doubt in my mind, they got to be certainly one of the big-time favorites this year. Forget about next year. This club is so deep, and they're so talented, and they play on a defensive end.
It's the third personal against Jamison. Now what's interesting is that with Wojo in there, Krzyzewski likes what he sees with Avery so far, and he's going to let him become the shooting guard in this situation as Greg Buckner, the 6'4 senior, coming back.
Well, see, he has
that goose egg. They need to get him in that scoring.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job containing Buckner, but they have done that all year long. They have shut down all the stars.
All right, partner, we'll be right back. 15-4, Duke leads Clemson. Prime time on ABC at 8 Eastern. Kevin Anderson in Nothing Sacred. One of the season's best dramas now kicks off Saturday night. All starts tonight on your ABC lineup here. It's all Duke right now, 15-4, partner, and they've got to find a way to shake Buckner loose here.
They got to get him loose, but, you know, Laurent Prophet went 0-for-7 against Duke, and North Carolina's C.C. Harrison, who can flat-out shoot the rock, an outstanding scorer, he went 3-for-7. Florida State's Terrell Baker got only 2-for-8. Robert O'Kelly, outstanding diaper dandy from Wake Forest, went 3-for-15 against him. They have a way of containing the star players. They really work so well together defensively. Suffocation.
Clemson only 2-of-8. Christie's open from outside the arc and missed the shot. Rebound, Blue Devils. It's Langdon.
That's the first good look they had today, Brett.
Yeah, they was wide open over there, Dick, and he couldn't make it. McLeod on a pull-up jump shot. That's it. And the Devils are on an 11-0 run right now. 4.5 minutes, and they've outscored Clemson 11-0.
And it's created because of their solid defense. They take such pride, each guy. You watch each guy pressure the basketball.
That's a freshman hounding Buckner. Foul going to the basket was Christie, and so he will be shooting free throws.
I'll tell you one thing, we keep saying freshmen, but these kids, I guarantee you, with all the experience they've had, playing in all these tournaments, they are unbelievable. You know, Michigan is the only team to beat Duke, as you see a little harassment here, and they beat them because of three factors. They out-rebounded Duke 45-29, they went to the free throw line, Brett, 36 times, and number three, they shut down Duke's perimeter game. Bullock and Trailer was sensational.
Avery gets a nice hand as he sits down. That means Wojo will want everything. Carowell.
I'll tell you one thing, everybody's waiting for February 5th, that showdown 8 miles up the road where they play some great basketball, lost there first. And I'll tell you, Bill Guthridge was class in winning. He was even classier in losing. A great, great guy.
Cloud forced back outside. Now comes in. A little off balance, offensive rebound. And there is Domzalski. Tamen Domzalski, a junior on the putback with his first field goal.
Not bad going to a guy that would have been all airport, sitting as the third best center behind Burgess and Brand. And you bring a guy like that in, it becomes a major factor.
Iturbe collides with Domzalski, and a foul called against the Devils.
I think the loss really hurt. It really hurt Clemson early psychologically. They lost to Gonzaga, John Stockton's team, led by a guard by the name of Matt Santangelo. One of those rigatoni specials. You know, lasagna guy, likes to eat the macaroni. He knocked down five trifectas to beat Clemson. And then they had that loss to Wake Forest, where they're definitely a better basketball team, but Wake played brilliantly to beat them.
Weidman and Mooney sit down. Nate Turbay's at the line for the Tigers.
Now Rick Barnes has really brought about excitement down there. The Little John is a great arena for basketball.
Bad pass, but Duke escapes a T.O.
Kamzowski very physical on the inside. He's got some good hands. Take a little right here to scouting report. Strength. He's got good upper body strength. There he is from out of New Mexico. Working, getting some PT. Had some injuries last year to both knees.
McLeod off the dribble. Kamzowski pounds inside. Left hand put back is there.
I'll tell you.
Is there interference? No,
yes,
basket.
Sir.
Basket interference. I think you can see a hand come up there at the end, and that's unfortunate for the Blue Devils because I think the ball would have gone in anyway.
Yeah, it would have went in, and Domzowski loses the deuce, but that's an excellent call by Freddie Barragan, who does a great job. So officials.
Freddie make that call?
No, Freddie, you know, as the supervisor, does a great job evaluating his people. And we're going to see it right here. Frank Scagliotti and company right on top of it. So you're not allowed to play with the ball once it's up on that cylinder. It's bouncing, it's bouncing, it's bouncing. It's going to get the Musburger bounce.
Farewell. He touched it.
Carroll, number 23, plays with it up on the rim. You cannot do it.
I think we've got a T on Barnes.
They called a T on him? See, we're so high up here. Yes, sir, they got a T on Barnes.
Langdon shooting.
Automatic. 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 He's like a 90% free throw shooter. He and Shamon Williams down here at North Carolina are automatic.
This continues. Coach might take the second one and get out of here.
He's automatic on that line. He and Rodriguez, the great shortstop, who's our guest here, having a blast today and this weekend, are rapping about baseball because he signed with the San Diego Padres. Saw too much of the curveball, hasn't one part of that anymore.
21-5 is the count. Rojo with a fine fake. Passed up the shot. Instead, it'll be Langdon. Jay is blocked.
Second time as Shea's been blocked tonight.
Lead pass now. Buckner rolling for the layup.
Here's Buckner. He's running a real scores in the ACC.
First field goal of the game, Dick.
Yep.
Carawell back. Off balance and it rolls in.
I mean, they got so many names they could hurt you with red. It's Carawell, it's Chappelle, it's Wojciechowski, it's Langdon, it's McLeod, it's Battier, it's Burgess. I mean, they hurt you with so many. You can't scout it. Contain one guy.
Turbay off the dribble. Rebound, Devils. Carawell puts it down, pounds it, left hand, switches.
They all handle the ball really well.
That pass to the inside.
And I didn't even mention Domzowski as Mike K. I tell you, I was telling him yesterday, I think this team's got a world of potential to be better than a club at 91 and 92. He said, no, not yet, with Leitner, Hurley, and certainly that fella, a fair player, Mr. Hill, they were special.
This team comes in now, and Langdon sits down, Dick.
But I'll tell you one thing, this team has the potential to be better. Look at this here. Best since, well, 93-94 season.
You know, eight players have scored already today for Krzyzewski.
Doesn't shock me. They get 38 points a game from their bench.
23-7, they lead it. 9:22 to go first half. Clemson with 7 points against this D. Wojo short off iron, run down by Weidman.
And Brent, you know they got 8 McDonald's All-Americans. They don't have any Wendy All-Americans. They got some McDonald's, baby. Oh, no, that's nothing against Wendy's. I like Wendy's.
Whip off the dribble, gives it up. Weidman is fouled, shoots free throws, but he didn't make the field goal.
Hey, Brent, when I was coaching, if you could get one McDonald's All-American, you as a coach would go absolutely bananas. I mean, when you think about most schools in America, to get 8 on your club is just incredible.
And that's the third foul on Domzowski.
Two shots.
Frank Scagliotta handled the ball to Turby on that line. Weidman rather.
I think we got a shot of Quinn Snyder, one of Krzyzewski's assistants over there on the sideline. And three Duke alums, three pretty good players over there. Johnny Dawkins, David Henderson, the other two.
I think it's great, Brent, that you have guys that all have the feeling for the passion for the school. Snyder, you mentioned Henderson and Johnny Dawkins. They all played at Duke. They understand what Duke tradition is all about.
23-7.
ball back toward it. Missed one. Got it.
Pass inside to Carwell. Scored and reamed to the line.
I thought they missed the partner, but they caught him with that diagonal pass. He was wide open on a baseline. A breakdown defensively. Movement without the basketball, a lost art in college basketball. Everybody wants to pound the ball. Now watch Carwell on the base. He's wide open. He's going to be wide open when they reverse the ball. There it is, the back screen. The back screen creates that opportunity, and Carwell converts.
If this continues, ladies and gentlemen, you are watching tomorrow's top-ranked team in all the polls. Oh. North Carolina was number one, and of course, they had an upset loss at the hands of Maryland, and now the Blue Devils are poised to jump back. Position, I think they held Dick for a couple weeks, didn't they, before they lost to Michigan and then they were knocked out.
How do you like this club? You watch it for the first time here. How do you like them?
I think they're wonderful.
They really are so skilled defensively.
Looney hits it for the Tigers. Chappelle quickly at the other end gets it right back.
I like him. He's silky smooth out of Southfield, Michigan. He's becoming a star here at Duke.
This is a quality basketball team, Clemson, and they're down with 9 points right now with 8:20 to go in the half. That's great defense.
And you're exactly right, Brent. They're a quality basketball team. This is not Cupcake City they're playing. This is no Three Puff Delight. This is a club that has beaten the likes of Florida State by 20. They've beaten South Carolina. I mean, they got some quality players. It is all in the
they are. Just on the shot. Tigers ball.
That was one of my favorite shows, All in the Family. It's so tough to come back when you dig yourself a hole like this against their defense.
There's just nobody gets open against them. Buckner.
And they really take pride in that. We saw it with the sliding drills. Alex couldn't believe it last night. Rodriguez, he said, what are they doing, doing all those sliding drills? I said, that's defense.
He slides pretty good on the double play, Buckner. The glass, score it. That's his second field goal in the first half.
Well, I would love to just represent Mr. Rodriguez and Mr. Griffin, and then close it right there.
You don't want much. Two potential Hall of Famers. Put around the cloud, doesn't get the roll, battle underneath. Clemson comes out firing.
Give it up.
Here comes
give
the
it up. Give
does
it up.
The McIntyre twist, score it on the line. That is a great move, and the foul is on Carwell. That was Terrell McIntyre's best move of the day.
Well, nice pass there. A little two-on-one break. Stay a little bit wider than the foul lane. Get about 16 feet apart because one man can't play both of you. Good play by Vince Witt. Excellent pass and great hang time. Great hang time by TM. This little guy is one of the premier point guards.
No, Dick and Clemson needs help, but like at the free throw line, they're only one of seven there. So they're leaving points at the line. You can't afford to do that here.
That's been one of their problems, though, basically throughout the year, shooting free throws. They've had bad, bad moments on that line.
Duke's lead is 14. We're going to take a break. We'll be right back.
Following college basketball, the Winter X game from Crested Butte, Colorado. Right now, Brent, let's take it back to you.
All right, John, thank you very much. Dickie B very happy to see that his school, Seton Hall, leads. Tommy Amaker, we wish him nothing but the best up there. Battier's shot is blocked by Christie, but he gets it back.
Tommy Amaker's got it up and down 10 days.
Avery has it picked.
Oh, straight
rolling.
He's an athlete. He's a runner and jumper. They're not going to back down. They got it down to 12. And a little timeout right there by Mike. Not happy. There he is now talking to the official. The intensity of Mr. Krzyzewski, Coach K, formerly a West Point cadet, played for the general, Robert Montgomery Knight.
Mike is still upset about something and trying to get it.
Yeah, he thought he got fouled there when he stripped the ball. I tell you, Clemson's had a tough time on Tobacco Road. Take a look at those numbers. Well, a lot of teams have had a tough time on Tobacco Road, though, I'll tell you that. You talk about quality programs.
Yeah, but none tougher than their record at North Carolina, where they're 0-43.
Yeah, they got the Ziggy down there, Zippo. North Carolina comes back today against Appalachian State, coached by a rising star and coach. And remember this name, Buzz Peterson, the former roommate of Michael the Magnificent in the 80s.
Just loses it. Another turnover now. Gotta be careful against this team. McIntyre passes off, and the foul's gonna go against. Goes against the Tigers on the charge.
He's got the charge out of control there in transition, a lack of communication. You got to talk to one another. Rick Barnes' club last year got beaten a Sweet 16. They had a good run, lost a tough game to Minnesota in overtime. Minnesota went on to the Final Four. Hey, what a year does Bobby Jackson's having in the NBA, played for Minnesota?
Yeah, he's a fine player, surprising a whole lot of folks.
These guys that have started, Johnny Dawkins was one. In fact, Johnny and Allery started together. Last combination to do that.
You know, Clemson has climbed back in this game. It is 28-16, and Avery answers it with the triple.
I'll tell you, he's a PT peer. No doubt about that diaper dandy. William Avery, when he gets his 30 minutes a night, starting next year, watch out for him.
Clemson ball.
Is that a dive and a scrap? That's a trademark here. Part of Duke basketball. You know, I mentioned Tommy Africa. I said he had up and down week. He beats Villanova. He gets a nice win there, and he gets blown out by Rutgers. And right now, Notre Dame had a great win the other day over West Virginia. And Garrity, what a Rhodes Scholar candidate. 35 thus far today.
McIntyre looks in, and Wojo, because they picked up the dribbles all over him. Bad pass as a result, and Buckner comes free with a loose ball for the field goal, 31-18.
Well, Buckner was posting on the inside, and he was being denied by Battier, but he got the loose ball.
Now McLeod muscles in on the inside to draw the foul.
The one kid that has to be a little bit more aggressive offensively is Shane Battier. He had 18 against Maryland. He has a tendency to be a little unselfish. Now, here it is. There's McLeod on the inside. Let's see if he leans in. Oh, yeah, that could have been offensive right there. That should have been an offensive foul.
Absolutely.
No doubt about it. He leaned in with the shoulder. He got away with that. Little Cameron crazies. I think made that happen.
5:47 remaining in the half. Deep roll.
And remember, we talked about halftime. The margin of victory at halftime has been better than 20 for Duke all year long. The closest has been Missouri, a -9.
Johnny Miller check back into the game for Coach Barnes.
He's a kid, Brent, that's not broken loose yet. Oh, look at that.
Chappelle is rejected by the Tigers. Outstanding defense. Lead pass. Witt again. Lays it in.
I'll tell you, Witt is an excellent transition player. He's a slasher.
You can't let him out like that. 32-20. Lead is at 12. Chappelle, jump shot. Short. Tigers again. They can cut that lead to 10.
Vince Witt did a great job blocking out there. Psychologically, your goal here, if you're Clemson, you want to get single digits at halftime.
McIntyre's got to give it up. And there was a whistle just prior to the pass. And a foul against the Devils.
His second attempt on the team.
Look at him trying to block out here. Look at Buckner on the inside. He tries to block out, holds him off, and then the ball pounces loose as he falls to the deck. A great rejection on Chappelle.
Now here's McIntyre. Free throws important. Remember, the Tigers have left points on that line. It's down to 11 now. This to make it a 10-point game as Langdon checks back in for and Carowell for the Devils.
They split last year. McIntyre has played well against Duke in the past. But to show you his value against Florida State, they outscore Florida State in 25 minutes when he's on the floor. 68-33. When he's out, they're -32-17.
There's your 10-point game, partner. 5:15. So the Tigers, mentally tough under Barnes, they hang in there.
Barnes said the toughest player he's ever coached mentally is Terrell McIntyre.
McLeod being hounded, gives it back to Wojciechowski. Langdon back inside to McLeod. Back now to the corner. In and out. Tigers ball. They can cut it to 8.
Yeah, Clemson really locking up on a defensive end as well. And they're known as a physical defensive team in their half-court game.
Witt takes the baseline. McIntyre keeps the dribble. Going to fire the 3. No. Rebound, Devils. Loose. Christie attacks. No. Tap. No, Devils.
What a turnaround. That could be a 4-point turnaround. Instead of getting it down to 8, it could go right now up to 12.
Wojo fires, puts it in Carowell's hands, open. Miss, rebound, and there's a foul underneath. Carowell and Battier were going for the loose ball and the fouls against the Tigers.
I'll tell you one area Clemson has done really well, Brent, is they have really contained a three-point shooting at Duke. Duke, who was on fire against Maryland, made 10 out of their first 11 from three, had nine big threes in the first half against Arizona. They've only knocked down two threes, I believe, thus far.
Things not Ray falling Buckner, the Blue Devils' way right now.
They had a chance to apply the knockout and they didn't get the knockout. I mean, Clemson is respectable right at this moment as you look at the free throw line. 4 for 10 for Clemson. I mean, does that hurt? You're down 10, you're on the road. You can't go on the road. You got to make everything work your way, all the special situations.
Remember now, Duke led this by 19 points at one time, and that lead is down to 11. Clemson ball.
Fitz Witt has given up a real spark off the bench.
Miller forced back out by Langdon.
Miller
was here's McIntyre.
He was outstanding when he played at Temple. Knocked out 9 threes this kid against Cincinnati in the NCAAs.
Coming down the baseline this time. Lay it up. No. Wave it off. Offensive foul. Call for the charge.
That's the fifth one today that they have taken, Brent. That's team defense, where they rotate over and they close off the driving angle.
No question about it. Timeout at the Cameron.
Payne Wibber College Basketball on ABC Sports. Brought to you by Toyota. Every day belongs to you. Make it count. Toyota, every day. The U.S. Army. Be a part of the toughest, smartest army in the world. Be all you can be. Head and Shoulders, because great hair can have flakes. And Priority Mail from the U.S. Postal Service.
Payne Wibber believes that the best investment is an investment in education. And today they salute Trajan Langdon and a $1,000 donation to Duke University for ongoing research. Payne Wibber, you can't lose with an investment in the future.
I'll tell you what a great story. A kid plays two sports, baseball professionally, basketball, and still maintains a better than 3-point average at a school of higher learning like Duke. You got to salute. He's a true student athlete, Trajan Langdon.
Run to the baseline right now. McLeod keeps it, and here is Trajan. Pump fake off the three. Kept the dribble as he went down. Turnover, though, and here's McIntyre. Eyes the floor. The Devils are there.
I'll tell you one thing. You got to be impressed with the guts and the heart of this Clemson team that they didn't fold.
Chance to cut it inside at 10 now. Iturbe passed up an open shot. Tried to improve his position. Did not. Probably should have taken the first look. Ojo sends it into the middle. Now McLeod pull-up jump shot. He's not bashful.
I tell you, he's not bashful. And right now, Wojciechowski's got to look for a shot. He's shooting better than 40% from three-point range. He's not thinking offense at all. He's becoming exclusively a passer.
Carowell pounding Buckner, 259, 33-22. Low-scoring, tough defensive game. Clemson digs back in late in the first half.
And they've dug back in because of their defense. See how they push you out? They don't let you execute that half-court offense. They extend.
Collides and fouls.
I'll tell you, Brad, I really believe when you talk about some super clubs in basketball, there are about six that are separated from everyone else. North Carolina, Duke, certainly Kentucky and Kansas, and UCLA and Arizona, and then I think it's the rest of the pack.
You get a good look on our game summary of how this is unfolding. Remember now, Duke led this by 19 at one time. In for Iturbe.
Would have been a lot closer had Clemson gone to that free throw line and converted, and that's been a problem for them at times this year.
Christie checks in. Chappelle replaced Carowell.
They lost to Kentucky earlier this year, and I really like that Kentucky team. Tubby Smith doing a heck of a job stepping in for the entrepreneur. Hey, Rick Pitino in 96 when he won the national title, and you love that team. Let me tell you something, they had 5 NBA first rounders.
Dickett is down to 9, 2:40. Great job here late in the first half. Langdon makes it 11 with a smooth-looking Jay from the baseline. 7 points.
He's got that speed jump shot. Tickles the twine. A little NBA, nothing by nylon, but the Alaskan assassin.
McIntyre over the top. Long three. No. Rebound McLeod for the Devils.
Shot an area code jumper from downtown Raleigh. That was too far out of his range.
McLeod stepped on the line, missed the two. Christie goes for it, fouled by Wojciechowski. So Wojo commits his third personal.
Well, the one thing with a guy like that getting foul trouble, he can go to the bench. See, he's a little too far out. I mean, that's NBA trifecta time. That's too far out for the little guy.
Just had to pull the trigger. You know, it's kind of itchy. You know,
yeah,
how that is?
It's, yeah.
Free throw time for Clemson, trailing by 11 at the 2:12 mark.
You get itchy once in a while. I know you get very itchy sometimes.
Yeah, got to scratch you. Tony Christie's at the line.
Christie's had himself a heck of a year. Last year he struggled, shot 25% from three-point range. This year, 47%.
Avery returns for the Devils. Ojo sits down. Point game right now at the 2-minute mark. Who would have thought that after Drew eased out to that 19-point lead? Langdon off the pass. Great move.
And that curl move to get him free at the three-point line, and he could flat out knock it down. Second in the history of the school, field goal percentage from three-point line. Number one, Christian Layton.
Dick, that three gives him 10 for the game, and the lead is back to 13 just like that. You said that Clemson's going to have to defend that three from Langdon.
Well, I told you before the game. Now, why don't you tell the people? I told you before the game, put 20 in your book.
I said,
Langdon gets 20. Put it down in your book.
And we did.
I said he's struggling, but today he'll break out.
He's halfway there, partner. Turvey.
Just watching the practice, he had that stroke going for him. Trajan, he was focused. He knows he's been struggling a little bit shooting the basketball.
Made both that time. 11-point margin, 147 left in the half. Now McLeod drives, no traveling called, and uses the glass for the field goal.
I'll tell you one thing, he has really become assertive offensively. He really thinks a shot almost on every possession out of the inside, outside performer, Rashawn McLeod. Not afraid to shoot the rock.
Barnes with the timeout.
And I mentioned Langdon's been struggling, 13 for 36 in his last three games. And they feel he's been trying to carry the load. As you see McLeod drawing contact, kisses it off the glass. They feel he's been trying to make things happen since Elton Brand went down with that injury. I wish you would get a chance, you would have gotten a chance to see Elton Brand. You would have loved him.
Leading scorer, leading rebounder for the Blue Devils when he went out with a broken bone in his foot. The pin was inserted. There he is. Complete recovery is obviously expected. The young man is a quality player and
what a
good student.
Great student. A great student. So beautiful to see young men like Elton Brand doing it the right way. Just like the Kansas program last year. 35-2 and he graduated all six players.
Great pass by Turvey. He missed the field goal and then Turvey gets it back and McIntyre misses the three.
That's a big three. That goes down. You cut it to 10. Now you're down 13 and they got a chance to go up 59. 16.
Avery will try for it. Missed it. Loose and a foul. Chappelle trying to run down the loose ball. He and McIntyre get tangled up and the foul is going to go against Clemson.
You know, even in their loss against Michigan, they were up so big in the second half, like maybe 16, and then it got away. I mean, no one's really challenged this club, obviously, other than Michigan.
The Blue Devils, number 20.
Our halftime report with John Saunders will be coming up. We've got a minute remaining here in the first half.
Comes up empty. I want to get in the studio, John. I'll tell you one thing. A pro's pro. But they talk about all those NFL shows. You started it all, partner, years ago.
Well, John Saunders does an outstanding job, Dick. I agree with you.
No doubt. He's a superstar. Oh, a little air ball right there. I'm getting John to buy me a dinner, man. Seeing all those great
things. He'll do it. He's a generous guy, aren't you, John? I'll send him to you, partner, if you want him. Turbay coming baseline. Great block. Nadier comes up with it away. And here's McLeod again, Dick. Misfiring. Rebound. Tigers, 39 seconds. Lots of time. No need to hurry. Witt. Back into McIntyre's hands. They could still make it a 10 if they can hit the three.
Here's Avery now with the challenge of trying to stop this little guy. Gotta watch the 5-second count. There it is. There it is. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. right.
Now, you like that. You like that rule.
Well, I like the rule because it makes defense important.
Now you hate that rule.
Well, I don't like seeing a guy having the ball for the whole shot clock. A great defensive play right there. Now, look at the defense right now by Avery. Why
not checking
reward?
The clock.
He's rewarding.
Why
defense.
Would you take the ball away from him right there?
Because
he checks the clock, keeps the dribble.
Yeah,
they're
he,
just maneuvering for a late shot. They're trying to take time off it, and you just gave the official another chance to blow the whistle. Here comes Langdon.
Oh,
inside corner. Rattled in from Chappelle.
And that's a backbreaker. That's a backbreaker. That's an Uncle Mo, man. That gives you locker room momentum as they sprint off. Plus 16.
And you could see Barnes. I knew what he was going to do. I'm looking at him, and he's yelling at the officials, and I don't blame him. Payne Weber College Basketball on ABC will be back after these messages and a word from our ABC stations. Back at the Cameron Indoor Stadium, a 16-point lead for the Duke Blue Devils. I'm Brent Musburger with Dickie B. Tell me, can anybody play with the Blue Devils now, or are they just going to walk into a national championship here?
Oh, there's teams that can play with them, because basically when you talk about North Carolina and certainly Kentucky and Arizona, Kansas, when they get back a healthy Rafe LaFrance, and you look at UCLA, those teams certainly have a shot at Duke.
Great defensive team, though, partner.
They are tremendous on a defensive end, and they're very deep. Their defensive tenacity is unbelievable. They are hellacious defensively. It starts with this guy. He's the catalyst. The little guy, Wojo, an old Rambo man. He makes it happen. Then look at the help. They rotate over. They took five charges in the first half, Brent. Very deep and very talented defensively, but certainly not an automatic to be a national champ.
Well, there are your numbers from the first half, but again, Clemson had cut into that 19-point lead. They'd reduced it to 10 a couple of times, and then they sort of let it get away from them at the end of the half.
Well, you know, Brent, when you talk about the three-point shot, I believe it's revolutionized college basketball. And you think in this situation here, it's changed the complexion of this game. You look at Duke, they've made five threes, and you look at Clemson, they've made zero.
And when you talk about defense, Turbe 0 for 4 in the first half. Christie 1 of 4. Buckner was 3 of 4. Didn't get that many shots. And McIntyre off the bench was 1 of 5. And there you see the Blue Devils leading scores. Langdon pacing the way with 10 points. But Rashawn McLeod was only 2 of 9.
Well, they do a great job, Duke, of zeroing in on the stars, and they do a great job of containment. Today, their concentration has been McIntyre and Buckner. They have really, really put the clamps on both guys.
The Blue Devil offense will operate right in front of Coach Krzyzewski now. Here is McLeod on a quick turnaround. His 10th shot scored and put him on the line.
He has really stepped up as a scorer. He has the mentality now. He thinks score, and he does that little isolation. He worked on that in practice yesterday, getting that one-on-one maneuver, trying to back a guy down, and then a little spin and shoot over the top.
One shot.
To start the second half for the Blue Devils.
And here comes the full court pressure. Starts with this guy right here, Wojciechowski. See how he gets down defensively? He gets into what he wants to do. DBT, drive him, beat him, and turn him.
Miller opens the second half as he did the game instead of McIntyre at the point. Here's Weidman. Zalski keeps him back outside. Turbe off the drive. Good left-handed layup.
And that's the first time I've seen today where no one rotated over to close off the driving angle. That is not team defense, what you've seen right there.
Away from the ball. That's Weidman committing the personal.
Look at Wojciechowski. Look at him. He doesn't have to score any points to be such a valuable player to this team. The catalyst. Look at him aggressively. Look at him. Putting a tremendous pressure on the ball.
Dick, let me correct that. That foul was on number 21, Buckner.
That's three on him.
McLeod again going. Didn't fall this time, but he's back on that free throw line. He feels it every time he touches the ball.
Yeah, he thinks he's Grant Hill now. I mean, he's starting to play like a superstar. He says, heck, get me to rock. He had that great game against Florida State when he scored 25. And look at Domzalski there. I don't speak Polish to him. See, he's speaking Polish to the referee. He doesn't understand what he's saying. Domzalski. Nobody had a shot to recruit him when Krzyzewski walked in with the kabasi. It was all over.
That's four fouls on Weidman.
Look how quiet it gets in here. See how quiet it gets? Look at this. Silence. First transfer that they've ever taken at Duke. Rashawn McLeod. I ask one question. How could St. John's allow this kid to get away? St. John's was another win that Tommy Amaka posted in this little recent run. He's had wins over St. John's, Villanova, and today Notre Dame, but got blown out by Rutgers and Kevin Bannon.
Turbe pulls away the miss. It's 47-29.
Look at Wojciechowski attacking. He knows Miller likes to shoot the three.
Miller spins, keeps the dribble.
Always stays between you and the basket.
It's on Chappelle, his second personal.
Look at McLeod right here. Look at him. He's talking to himself. What's he saying? I love you, I love you, I think. Can you read those lips? I love you, I love you.
See that way. Here's Buckner off the glass.
Who's he love? Loves that little round leather basketball. I spoke at a banquet one time for Magic Johnson at his All-Star game, and Magic did a whole thing for the kids, talking about how he used to go to bed at night with the basketball, saying how much he loved it and how it was going to change his life. What a passion, enthusiasm he had when he played the game.
His left-handed dribble, and he is cut off back outside. Here comes McLeod again, and this time he nails the three. That's 13 points for Rajan McLeod. He does love it today.
Every possession, he's thinking shot, shot. What a mentality he has developed. And a bounce in the stands. And Cameron Frazier has not been here since December 10th.
They're up firing, not there, knocked away into Wojciechowski. Wojciechowski's possession puts it up the floor to Langdon, and here come the Devils again. Oh, yes.
He's
in serious trouble now.
When he gets on fire, you better get a T.O., baby. Mr. Barnes, the Dukies are on fire. And the Cameron Frazier's are going bananas. And Mr. Busberger loves the Dukies. Oh, look at an offensive foul right there. Kicked it back out. Rashawn goes, nothing but nylon. And then Trajan says, anything you can do, I can do better, Mr. McLeod. And he knocked one down. So let me ask you, partner, how do you like this club?
I think it's an outstanding team. I'd like to see Kansas with LaFrench healthy. I think the one chance that you've got against him is down in that low block, having lost Brand, Dick. I think that's a big loss for the Blue Devils.
I do. I agree with you. I think you're going to have a little bit more inside and outside. And I think Kansas is going to get better and better with this injury. They're going to grow from it because Chenoweth, who had 20 rebounds the other day, and also Lester Earl is rebounding, getting a lot of minutes for LaFrench out of the lineup.
Rejected by Domzalski. Here's Chappelle coming down the wing.
Everybody's saying, what about Utah? What about Stanford? Utah has not played the kind of competition these people hate. Hello!
Chappelle, put it down.
Hello! Get ready, little blowout city. Get your filler material ready, John Saunders and Mr. Busberger. This is blowout city.
Alex Rodriguez is getting an eyeful here. He can take it on back to the Seattle Mariners. The Cameron is alive.
And there goes Chappelle, showing he's more than just a jump shooter. This is explosiveness. And there's the little reverse. You and I said we loved him yesterday at practice. Silky Stew, number 20 from out of Michigan, Southfield, Michigan. What an environment. The best basketball environment for enthusiasm. Certainly there are other great places like Rock Chalk, Jayhawk, where today they retire Wilta Stilts jersey, number 13, who's the greatest, and people are not going to agree with this statement, the greatest athlete ever to play in the NBA, athletic ability, Wilt Chamberlain, the greatest player ever in the NBA, Michael Jordan.
Turbay's missed, Domzalski. 55-31. Stolen. Whip.
Nice
lead
catch.
Pass. Christie misses. Domzalski again, and here's McLeod. Up the floor, Wojciechowski cut off by the Tigers.
See how he knew?
Back to Wojo. Short. Whip.
Wojo hesitant shooting the basketball. He was looking for Chappelle because he knows he's a 51% three-point shooter.
Misses the J, and there's Domzalski dominating the glass right now.
I'll tell you, he gives him a physical presence in the box. Talked to Larry Donald, the fine editor and publisher of Basketball Times today. And he said, Dick, remember, Domzalski was a big-time recruit coming out of high school. He was a McDonald's All-American.
Chappelle.
They really run to that three-point line. Last year, they broke a school record. 278 trifectas.
McIntyre to the baseline. Turbe up, foul. He'll shoot.
You know, Brent, we could talk all we want about their offense. It has really been their defense that has created this margin over a very good Clemson
foul
team.
Number 20, Mike Chappelle, his third.
Now, see, look at this. Wojciechowski's looking for Chappelle. He knows he's a three-point shooter. And he gives it back to Wojciech. He said, Wojciech, you shoot 47%. You shoot it.
Two shots.
Some people would label Clemson as a big disappointment after being preseason top five in America. What they did this year, they didn't play all the cupcakes they used to play in the past. That certainly reflects your record. The crowd loves it. Mike Kay, Quinn Snyder, Johnny Dawkins. There's Johnny Dawkins, player of the year. I think about disappointments. I think Fresno State obviously has been a disappointment. Georgia's been a big disappointment. Louisville and St. John's, except now they've got a few wins. And Xavier's been a disappointment, even only four losses. People thought they would dominate this year the Atlantic 10. Rhode Island's been outstanding. When you see Jimmy Herrick's club with the kid Tyson Wheeler, they got a big date on ABC next week with Cincinnati, who's been on fire.
Knocked away on the pass to Battier. Carwell runs it down. Christie rejects it. Coming back again.
Not a good shot right there, Brent.
Rebound. Allen's back. The freshman puts it off into Miller's hands.
They feel Allen's back eventually. He's going to be a very good player once he gets some experience.
Score it for Miller and put him on the free throw line.
Well, a little Miller time right there. Johnny Miller, I'll tell you one thing. He's the kid I thought would be such an instant impact player at Clemson because he had so many brilliant moments under John Chaney at Temple. But he's had so many injuries as you see him hanging here. Knee injury, shoulder injury, surgery. That's such a bad.
Burgess, one of the freshmen, is in, and Domzalski to a nice ovation from the crazies.
I'll tell you, he started now three games in a row, and they appreciate his aggressiveness on the inside. Can you imagine how much better and how good they could be with Elton Brand in the middle?
It'd be illegal. 55-35, timeout.
Payne Weber College Basketball on ABC Sports. Brought to you by Payne Weber. When you invest with Payne Weber, you invest with more intelligence. The U.S. Army. Be a part of the toughest, smartest army in the world. Be all you can be. And State Farm Insurance. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
15-21 to go. Clemson pressure. They trail it 55-35. They need a ton of turnovers. And foul is going to be called against Miller. Dick, there was news around ACC country when we learned that Wake Forest coach Dave Odom had suspended his 7-foot center, Lauren Woods, and he thinks that young Woods needs some time away from the game of basketball. What's your feeling about what happened over there?
Well, you know, Lauren Woods, I think, puts a lot of pressure on himself. And I really believe he asserts so much pressure in terms of trying to come in and feeling that at 7 feet he has to be the answer with Tim Duncan graduating and being such a superstar at the collegiate and now at the NBA level. And it's unfortunate. I just wish he would play the game, have fun, enjoy playing. He's got some nice talent. And I mean, it's basically healthy for him to take a little break because Langdon now knocks down the three. Davey Odom has such a compassion and love for his players. By the way, he played with Chris Carrawell in high school in St. Louis. And Carrawell said the same thing, that he really put so much pressure on himself to want to excel. And all we can simply say, we hope that Lauren Woods gets back on the floor and doing what he does best, just enjoy and play basketball and have fun. Have fun.
Which is what Mike Krzyzewski told
his team. He's not having fun.
And yeah, there's one man who hasn't had fun all day long.
0-for-5 from the three-point line. That'll make you lose some hairs.
And Miller misses outside again.
Johnny Miller had to
Carwell, got to pick it up. Taps it over to Langdon. Goes for 18. Misses this time. Yanked back down by Jamison.
He's got to get another five to make my wish come through. If I had it a book there, 20 to start the game. There's Langdon out playing defense. Quick goes right by it. Matador defense right there by Trajan Langdon. I mean, that was Matador defense by TL. That's not Duke defense right there.
Yeah, yesterday. yesterday, the last thing that Krzyzewski said to this team was have fun tonight before you go back and enjoy what we're going to accomplish tomorrow. And they are enjoying the scene in here. Mike does such a great job with the personalities on this team. When you think about it, Dick, how about all the stars that this man handles over here on the sideline? That's not easy.
I think the psychology of coaching is so important. I thought Rick Pitino was a genius at Kentucky with that, when they had all those great stars in 96, to be able to blend them as a unit, to understand that it's the team and it's not I, it's we, and to play with that feeling. They do the same right here. I mean, yesterday was a joy. Our producer and our fine director, Drew Esikoff, and certainly Kim Belton, who was a former star at Stanford, was so impressed watching Duke practice and with the joy and jubilation that they practice with.
Put the name down, Quinn Snyder, who's over there on the sideline.
Yeah, he's
watched
going
him
places.
Operate this team yesterday in practice. Mike spent a lot of time just kind of filling us in, and Quinn Snyder was a hands-on coach, and I got to tell you, yep, if you're looking for a coach, there would be a good 60-37.
Oh, they lost Amaki. You trying to get him to lose this guy? Amaki's left here. He doesn't want to lose Quinn right now.
McIntyre nails the J for the Tigers.
There's Terrell, one of the premier guards in the ACC.
Yeah, I wonder, you've been down to Clemson. You've done games down
yes,
at Clemson.
Yes, beautiful.
They still got the sets on over at the Esso Club. They never walk away from this game, even though they're getting ripped.
I'll tell you one thing, down at Clemson, they created so much excitement. See, Burgess is the guy that's got to really step up. He's the one guy to give him a little more inside, as you talked about. And Little John is alive and well. That place is a great basketball environment, created by Rick Barnes this year and last year with the success he's had. Came from out of Providence. Providence he replaced, great trivia question. Everybody thinks he replaced Pitino, but he did not. He replaced a guy named Gordy Chiesa, 1 year, who's now an assistant to Jerry Sloan in Utah. Chaz? Here's a kid that they've been waiting to become a star. Vince Witt, the sophomore, super south, had some great moments last year. This year had a brilliant game in their win over an emotional battle, intrastate rivalry over South Carolina. 17 points against him.
Avery. Jump ball.
See, if you're Clemson right now, you're down 19. What you're trying to do, basically, you got to sell your kids, we play this game in segments. And right now, let's get down to that. Let's work diligently to try to get to about the 8-minute mark to where we can get it to 10. If we can get a little spurt here and get it to 10 with 8 on the clock, maybe now momentum goes our way. So that's how you try to play the game. You play it in little segments.
You know, Dick, you spend so much energy trying to come back into a game against Duke, that you wonder at this point whether or not they would have anything left then to get over the mountain. Remember, twice late in the first half, they cut it to 10, and there was nothing left in the tank.
Well, you know what happens against Duke? They go to their bench, and they don't bring in any weakness at any spot on the floor. They may bring in somebody better from the bench than what they had on the floor. That's unbelievable.
There's Wood off the dribble. Weidman, baseline. And it's Domzalski clearing out again.
I'll tell you one thing, he is really becoming a space eater on the inside.
Wojo missing.
He's got
loose.
30.
Taps it over to Langdon beautifully.
You know, Wojo's got 30 threes this year, second to Langdon, who has 35, so he can shoot the three.
Inside, the foul is going to be called on the drive by McLeod.
Wojciechowski's got a great basketball IQ. He's always thinking on the floor. Now look at this right here. See the little thinking? He knows he can't grab the rebound there, but he slaps it to his buddy, Trajan Langdon, who's talking about a great basketball IQ. Mr. Langdon has a great feel for the game as well. I still like North Carolina, though, Grant. I really do. I think the bottom line is if they can stay out of foul trouble, see, if you can get into their bench, then they have problems. And Maryland was able to get into their bench, and that created a problem at the end of the game. Fatigues became a factor, and the kid Jamison was 1-for-5 in overtime, basically on the free throw line. But they got a bunch of winners, and they haven't missed a beat in the transition from the Hall of Famer Dean Smith to Bill Guthridge. And just, I can't say enough on what a classy guy and what a super job he has done.
Cloud for point number 15.
You know, the best start they've had at Duke has been 21-1, and that was a 92 season, where they went back-to-back in 91-2, winning the national titles.
Here's another reminder of what's ahead tonight. There's your lineup on ABC starting at 8 Eastern, 7 Central. .12:30 to go here. It is 62-41 Duke.
So difficult to get a spurt against Duke where you can get a 10-1 run or 12-2 run, because eventually within a 3-minute span they'll usually come back up with a big three or a big play.
McIntyre pulls up with the jump shot. 9 points for Terrell.
You gotta like Terrell McIntyre. He's a lot of guts and heart playing out there. Has not practiced in 3 weeks. Didn't practice yesterday. They're saving him for the game.
The weave to take some time off the clock. Langdon fires. Offensive rebounds. It is McIntyre. Putting it down on the floor now. Coming in from behind. Hits over on the wing.
He can really push the rock, the little guy.
Double dribble on Jamison on the turnover. Goes over to the Devils.
Jamison's been a non-factor here tonight.
62-43. We got a timeout. 11:45 remaining. Duke with a big lead, 62-43.
Well, take a look at the two little guys under 6 feet. You see 0 points for Wojciech, so you say, well, he hasn't been a factor. Forget about it. He's been a major factor with his defensive pressure. McIntyre with 9 points and 3 assists, not getting any help on the inside. Jamison has really struggled here tonight.
After a huge game against South Carolina.
Yeah, 13 points, 13 rebounds, and 11 on the offensive glass. Last year here, he had 18 points and 8 rebounds. Today, he's got 0.
McLeod turns around, nails the field goal, and is fouled.
See, what McLeod has given him now, Brent, he's given him another guy who can score on the box inside, a post player. He can play on the perimeter, but now they're utilizing him inside in that area as well. Now, watch him down inside. They get a little two-man game. Wojciechowski throws him the ball. And now he's going to have that little spin. Likes to shoot that turnaround J. You know, Buckner's averaging 20 points a game in the ACC, and he's been contained. See, here's Wojciechowski's value playing on that end.
McIntyre off iron, rebound Jamison.
Jamison's got that great body. He was a tight end in high school. Many people thought he'd be a super football player.
Christie drives, gives it up. Allen's back short, and Christie puts it back in.
There's Christie with the offensive rebound. Hey, speaking about football, we were entertained this morning and last night by the North Carolina football staff over at that beautiful restaurant at the Siena that you and I and all our people had dinner at, Alex Rodriguez and company. Mr. Torbush and his staff were recruiting big time.
Paul Torbush. Places Mac Brown and moves down to Texas. He's doing nothing but the best. Cloud misses. Nice fella. Good to see him get a chance. Buckner. The ball on the floor. Brings it up. Down the line. And a foul called against the Blue Devils. It's against McLeod, who wanted a jump ball.
Look at the body on him. He's got some pins on him. I mean, wow. Jamison so strong. Free throw line has been a real troublesome area for him throughout his career, even though he's had some good moments. In certain games, he was 12 for 13 last year on a free throw line here against Duke. So he likes these rims. He is a big guy. There's no doubt about it. Look at those pins. I mean, he's in the Arnold Schwarzenegger class. He doesn't have my body, a Pee Wee Herman
Shane
body.
Shane Battier back into the Blue Devil lineup, replacing Cameron Gonzalez.
Look at that right there. What's good at all that money? You got 0 on a board here. Come on, Brett. Come on now, you and I could go out there and get 0. You and I could go out, we get Saunders. The three of us could go out there and get the Zippo.
Please, Jamison, make this one. No.
Oh, if you can't have fun.
Oh, we got a violation, another chance. Come on, Harold.
Come on, Harold, knock one down.
6'8 junior from Vance, South Carolina.
We don't want to see Zip up there for you.
Too strong. Here's Buckner, high off the glass, misses, put back, miss. Yanked back down now by Turbe, who put it in, scored, and he'll come to the free throw line.
Good offense.
Finally, the Tigers are saying.
Yeah, good offensive rebound right there by Turbe. The one thing is, though, when you're getting into the offensive glass, that means you're still still fighting, scrapping, and clawing.
You know, Dick, you talked about the threes. The Tigers came into this game averaging five successful three-point field goals a game. They have been held to the goose egg today by this Duke defense. That, as much as any statistic, will tell you the story of this game. 65-47 Devils, 10:28 to go.
Well, that guy right there puts his game plan together, Mr. Krzyzewski, and he looks at the strengths and weaknesses of a club, and they really attack it with a purpose and focus. That intensity that he generates is just so special. I mean, you're not gonna play and get any PT playing time if you don't play and give an honest effort.
Long three, Wojo misses. Off Carawell, and the official says no, it was hit by Clemson.
You know, Wojo was the leader in the ACC in steals last year with 82. This year, he's in third in the conference. Ron Proffitt is number one for Maryland. Maryland's won three in a row. Big win over Florida State, and then that major, major W over North Carolina.
Wow, crashing through travel.
I think he loves to score. McLeod likes that feeling of scoring. He's a BMC, big man on campus.
20 seconds.
Look at Mike, look at Mike. You would think they're down 25. I mean, that's why they're so good, because he doesn't let them really get away from their focus and their concentration.
Well, a staff of very successful assistants who all played here, Dawkins, Henderson, and Snyder. He says it is important to keep that tradition intact with his coaching staff, and I know you agree.
I agree with that as you look at the numbers. They do it at North Carolina as well with Phil Ford, Dave Anders, and also Pat Sullivan. I think that is special when you do that, because those guys understand what the tradition is all about. And I think it's special schools football. I think if I'm at football at Notre Dame, you want guys that have worn that uniform to feel that pride of what it's about in that locker room.
Miller coming baseline to baseline. 65-50. The lead is 15. 10 minutes. Still time for Clemson to stage a comeback here, but it's going to be uphill, going to be tough.
Well, see, they got it to 15, Brent. And if they're going to get that three-point line to work their way, Duke's not able to knock them out with that 25-30 blowout, it seems. They've been putting on people.
Langdon coming through, and Miller hooked him.
Try these margins of victory. This is not against cupcakes. 32 on the road against Maryland, 44 on Virginia, 36 on the road against Wake Forest. I mean, those are incredible numbers.
21, Trajan Langdon. Langdon steps to the line.
He's automatic on the line, Brett. Just a great free throw shooter. And it's so important down the stretch in close games, something they haven't been playing, that in close games to have people like that that are going to touch the rock a lot late in the game. He's automatic. I mean, he's just automatic on that line. Bends his knees, gets that good release for you young kids, the follow through, great rotation, backspin.
Here comes Miller. Charging is the call against Miller this time.
That's about the seventh charging foul here today. And that, again, is all part of the puzzle of putting together a solid defensive team effort. See, now watch. He'll beat this guy. He beat Langdon, but who's there? Shane Battier rotates over in rotation, squares the body, and takes the charge.
I think it is safe to say if Duke hangs on, they certainly will be number one in the polls. Not necessarily a position you want to be in college basketball, because you become the hunted. You want to be number one after the tournament. But Duke certainly is headed in that direction with their performance here today against Clemson. Here's Carawell twisting, comes back up firing, and he is fouled.
They'll be number one, and I'll tell you, when I voted my poll for AP, I'm not going to penalize North Carolina severely with that overtime loss. I would put them at number two. I really mean that. I'd put them number two. Losing on the road is Cameron Crazy's not really going bananas today. I mean, a little relaxed. Classes just started this week. Getting a little nervous time, worrying about that second semester, getting that GPA. Look at Scagliotta. Look at him right here working like he's a football coach. He's a high school football coach. He's like 9-2, they told me today. He's an unbelievable football coach on a high school level. See, these referees do more than just blow the whistle. Look at this. He's doing his homework. Look at him read it. Wow. That's a she. Look at her. She's doing her homework here. Wow. So look at it, he turns around, what's going on? What is she reading? That's a little philosophy. Wow.
I wish I would have studied
Harvard. Doesn't take much to set you off, partner. Nice to be back.
I wish I was, I wish I was a better student when I was in school.
9:16 to go. Farewell.
Hey, I feel this way, and I really sincerely mean it. I may be 58, but I act about 12. And if you can't get excited about making a living doing what we do, there is something wrong, my friend, something wrong.
Buckner hands it off. And that lead, Dick, is back to 19. Just moments ago, it was 15. A walking called on Jamison and gets it off the glass for the field goal. His first points of the afternoon.
Yeah, Jamison, his first deuce. And my producer yells in my ear, I'm giving myself too much credit to be 12. I'm really about 7, he says. Thank you, Mr. Belton.
Knocked away from Langdon. And Zalski.
Jump ball, alternate possession. Here we go. Alternate possession goes to Duke. So you penalize the defense again. That rule is absolutely stupid. Absolutely ludicrous, absurd.
What do you really think about it, Dick?
Oh, I've been screaming at it. Doesn't mean anything. Nobody listens, Brad.
8:46. Fire and missing, Avery.
Oh, nice catch.
Jamison.
Look at Jamison trying to make like a tight end. Like a tight end with the catch. 15, I'll tell you, the respectability. You got to give credit to the Clemson kids for not folding. I can tell you that. A lot of teams just absolutely fold with that blistering pressure they put on.
Tom McIntyre.
I know Duke's not looking forward to going to play down a little, John. I can tell you that. Down a Coliseum down there in Clemson.
His mother, Cheryl McIntyre Cunningham, been watching here today. I had a chance to chat with her before the game. She came up to watch Terrell here today and said that the foot just on the inside there, see? In the white cap.
Get out of the way. Let Cheryl get some PR. Come on, back up. Back him up. He's got the Ken Griffey look. Look with the hat on back. He's going to back up. She wants some AT. Come on. Give Cheryl some AT. She's so proud of her son. And she should be. He's a good, good kid. You know, Clemson's had some outstanding teams. Bill Foster did a great job when he was there. They were 23-9 and 79-80.
So Wojo's first point comes at the free throw line with 8:22 to go. But again, as Dick has pointed out all game long, he's running the floor very well.
That's what he is. He's a floor. Cliff Ellis won the ACC regular season when he was here. He was there prior to the arrival of Rick Barnes. He went to the Sweet 16 in 1990. Buckner's had a tough time today getting his shots, Greg, getting the number of opportunities.
Survey, no.
Take it up!
Take it up! He puts it in again.
Take it up with that big, strong body.
Just inside of the 8-minute mark.
One thing Clemson is neutralized, they're not letting Duke get out now in the second half here with a lot of offensive transition layups. They're making it a half-court game, which means you take some time off the clock. And Duke's got to execute here in their half-court game, trying to get a back screen.
Michael tried to look at Avery a lot down the stretch here now. Missed on that shot. Battier has knocked away from him. McIntyre comes up, and he is fouled by Carwell.
Well, it's 15 now, Brent. You got a lot of time on a clock. We've seen so many miracles happen throughout the years of college basketball. There's a little flatness now, right now, in this arena, both from the fans and from the Duke Bell ball club.
Fouls on number 23, Chris Carwell, is second.
You start converting some free throws here, get into a little full court pressure, make a steal or two.
One.
Get it to single digits. That psychologically gives such an emotional lift to your play. He makes this point. He's a 1,000-point scorer in his career. Gets that beautiful ball to present him. It's at 999. He's got 1,000. He's got 1,000. That's 1,000 more than me.
Maine Weber College Basketball on ABC. We'll be back after these messages and a word from our ABC stations.
Next, it'll be the Winter X Games with Border X and Snowcross. Right now, let's take it back to Brent.
John, thank you very much. 71-58, the Blue Devils with the lead, and Clemson trying to ease back in this one. Here comes Buckner for the layup, scored it, put him on the line, and the Tigers now have stepped up to the line here in the last 8 minutes. 7:18 to go, and the lead is suddenly down to 11, and Buckner can make it a 10-point game.
Well, that's what we talked about a little bit earlier, try to get this to single digits within a four-minute spurt. Here's Buckner out in transition. He's got super strength to his body, great inside-outside guard. He's the kind of guy you can invert. Here's a look at the game summary. Look at Clemson, 0-6, Brent, versus 8-22 on a three-point line. That's the big difference.
Buckner makes it a 10-point game, and Mike Krzyzewski.
This flat is here.
Starters back in. Domzalski is on the floor along with Langdon. Battier stays. Avery and Wojciechowski together. There's a
look
steal.
At this.
Here comes Witt for the driving layup.
Jam City.
They are alive in Clemson.
Get
for
a T.O.
right now. 71-63.
Going to get a T.O., Brent.
They pull to within eight and plenty of time. 7:04. Krzyzewski needs to talk about it, and he will.
It's flat right now. It's been very flat here the last 4 minutes.
We've got some stunned crazies. The Tigers on the comeback. We'll be right back. Crazies are finally alive. Your lineup for Big Monday, Connecticut, St. John's, Kansas, Missouri, TCU against Surprising Hawaii on ESPN. Duke needs a field goal right now to quiet things down. Here's Battier, the freshman being hounded by Iturbe. Puts it into another freshman's hand, Avery, and Witt will defend him. 6:47, 71-63. Avery, short rebound, loose. Duke comes back up on the inside. Langdon, huge moment for the Devils.
That's a big moment, Brent. Tremendous offensive rebound by Trajan Langdon. They've been struggling here. Now it's up to 10 for eight. Rick Barnes got to be a little upset there. They come up with a missed shot. He's got to come down with this rebound, but Langdon rotates to the inside. It pops to Langdon. Here's the catch, and here's the kiss on the glass.
Dick, the guy who cleared everybody out was Domzalski underneath with both his arms. One of the differences in this game has been Domzalski's muscle in underneath when he's on the floor, and that allowed Langdon to quickly jump in there. We could see that very well on our director Drew Esikoff's picture there, our producer Kim Belton. We thank our crew today. 74-63 now, and the Tigers will face some pressure as they bring it up.
Every possession big right now for Clemson, down 11. Duke extended a little bit more defensively.
McIntyre, Wojo's got him far away from the basket.
I tell you one thing about these Clemson kids, there's no quitting them.
Fires the three up over. Off the glass. He calls the bank shot and puts him right back in at 74-66 in 6 minutes.
Tell you, McIntyre gets that banker to go down.
Now it's Avery's turn with the defender.
That's the first trifecta they made here tonight.
Cut off, and the taller Witt stays right with him, and he can't get it to fall, but it's Battier back in.
I'll tell you, Brad, offensive rebound has been the difference in the last two possessions.
Absolutely.
Battier and Langdon.
Absolutely.
They've done a great job with their team defense, Clemson, but they don't come up with the rebound.
Clemson needs to cut it inside at 10 again now. Witt trying to slice through off of Langdon, and there's a foul call on Duke.
I'll tell you one thing, there's a bigger stride and a real bounce in the action by the Clemson kids. Now here's Battier going to come up with this offensive rebound with the long, long arms. And there's the reverse little, oh, what a nice play by Shane Battier. Now look at McIntyre. I mean, he's going to open the bank right now. He's going to open the bank. He says, I'm going right off the bank, baby. I'm going right off the bank, right off the glass.
He did one that thing, Dick, and you pointed it out. The key to this game is the fact that Barnes' team did not quit. Mentally, this is a tough team. May not be as deep or as talented, but these kids have hung in to give themselves a chance.
They have really been aggressive. They got to make foul shots now. You want to stay and hang close. You got to convert. Vince Witt's had some big moments here in the second half. As you look at Rick Barnes, he's done a heck of a job. Sweet 16 last year, preseason, top five. He's got five L's this year.
Short. Pulled away by the Tigers. Here comes Jamison, high off the glass, yanked away by Battier, the freshman. At both ends, he contributes to the Blue Devils. 5.5 minutes to go now, 76-67. Avery over to Wojciechowski, who looks in.
Take some time, walk that clock, get the high percentage shot.
Here comes Langdon, far outside.
He's been solid today. Trajan Langdon's been solid.
Turned it over. Turned it over. Turned it on the dribble. Goes over to the Tigers.
Got a carry. This is another now big possession. This will be the closest. Remember this now. Duke was up 16. They were up 16 on Michigan in the second half and lost.
And Dick, they were up by as many as 24 in this game.
And they were up and they were only lost. They were plus 16, and then Michigan went on a run.
Down toward 5'10", which slices in. Great pass to Jamison.
They've been waiting for the big guy to explode. He's been quiet all day.
8 for Jamison, 5 minutes.
Stay tuned, baby.
7 points, the lead is down to.
I think there's some Tar Heel fans jumping with joy, saying, come on, come on, come on, Clemson.
Just a little bit.
There's a little double stack, Duke runs now, trying to get a little clear off the penetration.
Ojo looks open, man, it's Avery, the other freshman. Great fake, little pull-up jump shot, misses, put back Battier, no. Yanked away by Iturbe, looks down the floor, and here they come. They trail it by 7 right now. Iturbe picks it up. And here's McIntyre, goes for the tray, got another one.
I'll tell you, you're seeing what this kid's made of. Playing injured, he's just knocked down 2 trifectas.
The lead is 4, Dick.
We got a 4-point game, baby.
76-72 at 4:17. They've come eyeball to eyeball with the Blue Devils here at the Cameron.
The momentum right now on the Clemson side.
Here's Avery, Witt is there, the taller man. Lojo far outside, tries to position Domzalski.
It looked like we were going to have a blowout when he got up to 24. It looked like blowout city. Put the Fuller material away.
Can they regain control of the game? Lojo gets a defender in the air, misses it. Ed Domzalski misses the tap. Tie it up underneath, jump ball. Jump ball, alternate possession. It's Clemson's ball.
Clemson's ball, the alternate possession.
You got to remember this, as McIntyre knocks down the trifecta, that Clemson in the last 2 years has beaten Duke 4 of the last 6 times. And there's Jamison catching it. Look at that body. Where has he been? A guy with that physical body has got to be a presence throughout the entire game. He has stepped it up here late in the second half.
One thing about a young team, and make no mistake about the young team at the Blue Devil end, Mike Krzyzewski with the Blue Devils grouped around him. You look for leadership in a situation like this. I know he has Wojo, but this is where you look for your seniors to step up big time as they come out 76-72, and there's not a lot of experienced leadership on hand for the Devils. And it worked against them, as Dick pointed out, in the Michigan game, and that's something they have to overcome here against Clemson. The lead now, once 24, is down to 4.
It's
3:49 to go.
Here's where Wojciechowski and Langdon got to make the big plays, the catalysts and the leaders of their club.
McIntyre's been on fire. He's hit a couple of trays. Turby steps it out, puts it on the floor. Jump shot's there, off the glass. No, too wide open. And underneath, as they pull it away, the foul is against Clemson.
Well, Langdon out of the lineup right now. The Duke right now being tested big time by Rick Barnes's club, and he's got to be proud of their effort right now, but he wants more than just effort. He knows there's plenty of time to maybe steal a W here. They got flattened at one moment. The crowd got flat. And I'll tell you something, they're paying big time because this club is so tough mentally, the Clemson team.
It's interesting, the substitution pattern. Carowell now comes in. Avery is back out. Chappelle is at the free throw line, and he zips one in to make it a 5-point Duke lead. Wojciechowski, of course, still on the floor. Battier coming down the stretch for Duke. So the one freshman stays in to pound on the glass. 2 big free throws for Chappelle, who's out there with Carowell right now.
Chappelle, a good shooter. I tell you what's really big, the 2 offensive rebounds that Duke was able to get in a crucial moment to keep them up 6.
Inside, Jamison slams another one coming down the baseline on that internal pass. Nobody there.
Well, where has he been? Where has Harold Jamison been? And that was created off the dribble penetration and the attacking of the defense by Vincent Witt, a slasher.
Domzalski's wide body is out right now. 78-74. Duke's lead is at 4.
McLeod looks like the number one option offensively. They're going to step up and put McLeod involved.
Against Clemson.
See the dribble penetration right here. Witt beats Carowell, and then there's the dish off. Defense has to step out, and Jamison, who had 0 and was being blanked, has really stepped up in the last 10 minutes.
Cloud will step up to the free throw line. Blue Devils leading by 4 and 3 minutes to go.
I'll tell you, life in the ACC, what looked like it was going to be a blowout, looked like it would be an easy win, has turned out to be a nail-biter, a Bailox time right now.
And Duke must keep an eye on McIntyre, capable of gunning that 3 from downtown. They're going to need one, it looks like, before this baby's over.
Well, Mike Krzyzewski told us he thought this would be their toughest test.
Free throw, rebound Clemson, and now here they put it back in McIntyre's hands. As we go down inside of 3 minutes, 79-74. Cut off, Iturbe, off the dribble, running past, wanted Jamison in that same spot. The ball was deflected out of bounds.
Iturbe, such an outstanding passer, especially in traffic. Take a look at the average margin of victory this year. Better than 32 points a game, and they've been blowing people away all year long.
Open is Buckner, land.
Nice special situation.
It's a three, Dick.
Yeah, it's a three-point game. Buckner stepping up. Remember, this club has beaten some quality teams over the last 2 years.
2:42 now, and they're right there with them. The Devils need a field goal battle.
Well, you know, last year they beat Kentucky, they beat Duke, they beat Florida State this year. I mean, they can play. They have a nail biter with North Carolina.
Carrowell going to call a timeout. 12 seconds left on that shot clock, and they're going to talk about it over on the side. It's 79-76. Duke once led by 24.
And this crowd is stunned. I'll tell you, Brent, this crowd is stunned. You and I talked about it when they were even up about 15, that it got very flat in here.
We're going to take a break, and we'll stay right through this at 2:22 remaining here in regulation. Amazement they have seen this lead dwindle away against a very tenacious Clemson team. You cannot say enough about the youngsters and the coaching job being done by that Tiger staff.
Well, he's got a great assistant there as well, and Dennis Felton, but Rick Barnes has a personality that's reflected by his players' enthusiasm. He's a fighter, he's a competitor, and you can see that kind of attitude today. Most teams would have folded when we were down 24, and Duke was playing brilliantly defensively, but he never allowed his kids to quit. He kept his poise, he kept after them, and they just kept coming back, coming back.
We welcome those of you who just joined us with Dick Vitale. I'm Brett Musburger. A little ACC madness at the Cameron Indoor Stadium. The Duke Blue Devils were leading the Clemson Tigers by 24 points. The lead is down to 3, 79-76. Duke with the lead at 2:22 to go. Duke called a timeout to talk about it with 12 seconds left on the shot clock. It will be Duke's basketball, Dick.
I tell you one thing. I think he's got to get Trajan Langdon back on the floor. Well, here he is. He's coming out now. They need him out there because if this gets to be a free throw shooting contest late in the game, remember, he's a 90% free throw shooter.
Chappelle, Battier, Langdon, Wojciechowski, and McLeod.
I tell you, Brad, you and I are stunned. We got ourselves a barn burner here, baby.
Now remember, only 10 on that shot clock. They called that timeout with 12. So Duke doesn't have a whole lot of time. McLeod shot rejected. Loose underneath, gonna be Clemson ball.
Back it
and
out.
Witt's gonna pull it back out. Wojciechowski would not give him a driving layup. Inside of 2 minutes, the lead is 3. Clemson down, and here is Witt off the dribble. Pull-up shot, no. Rebound Duke, it is Langdon.
Langdon becomes big in his sequence because if he can get to the line, he's automatic. He's matched up with Buckner, two of the better guards in the league.
Chappelle is open on the left wing. McLeod's got the ball.
I'd get Langdon some shots. I'd get some screens, use some time, try to run that clock down.
They put it back in Wojciechowski's hands, the senior point guard. Runs it over to the left, and here is McLeod. Will take the three. No. Off iron, loose. Knocked away by Witt. Loose, and here's Buckner for the Tigers. 1:28. Buckner cut off.
Bring it out.
And the foul is going to be called.
I think you got a timeout.
A timeout. Timeout is the call by Clemson. You're absolutely right, Dick. It's only a 20. They want to talk about it with 30 seconds left on the clock. So now, Dick, what do you do? 1:23 left in the game. 79-76 Duke.
Well, I'll tell you one thing I would do right now is play a little two-man game between McIntyre and Buckner. I would try to get them involved with each possession.
We'll find out what happens here at the Cameron Indoor Stadium when we return. 30 seconds left on the shot clock. The Tigers have their play set during that timeout, and it's an inside layup. It's a beautiful call by Barnes. Iturbe laid it back in to make it a one-point game. They set it up perfectly.
I'll tell you one thing, Brandon. Two possessions under the basket. They've got two conversions, showing again the importance of special situations. Advancing the ball from the baseline.
Bojo cut back off, 79-78. Duke with a one-point lead. Langdon fires off the pass, and it's back to three with the J by Trajan Langdon.
That's the guy they wanted to go to. They ran a special play with a double stack and curled him out. He got the ball in there. Great shooter's
hand. McIntyre now penetrates, has to give it up, and Jamison's right there for the slam again. Makes it a one-point game.
That's the third time that he's done that. The third time, a little jam from that baseline, a penetration by McIntyre.
Now protecting the basketball is absolutely critical. 81-80, Duke, 34 seconds to go. Bring the shot clock down. They're bringing seconds off of it. But Clemson knows they're going to get the ball for at least one more shot. Wojciechowski penetrates, going to bring it back. McLeod on the screen gets it back. Now McLeod comes into the paint. Short. Clemson ball.
Clemson with a chance to win this game, Brett.
McIntyre down to 15 seconds, 81-80. McIntyre doubled up McLeod. Wojo's tied him up.
Nice
tied him up. And it goes over to Duke. Ball belongs to Duke, 10 seconds left. I believe Krzyzewski wants a 20-second timeout here. He has 120 to go, and he's going to use that 120-second timeout right now. So the Tigers come back out now defensively with 10 seconds to go. Dick, one that got away from them.
Well, I'm surprised they didn't call a timeout when they got possession of that basketball. Managing the clock at the end of the game is so important. I'm really shocked when they got the ball that Rick Barnes didn't utilize a timeout.
Battier puts it in Wojciechowski.
Oh,
they turn
shot.
It over. He hands it off Wojciechowski, and they turn it over on that far side. Clemson ball, 9.6, and now timeout Barnes.
He uses
what a turnaround.
He uses the last timeout right now, Brent.
This is not supposed to happen at Cameron Indoor Stadium. We'll be right back.
Payne Weber College Basketball on ABC Sports and Raycom. Brought to you by Payne Weber. When you invest with Payne Weber, you invest with more intelligence. Rogaine Extra Strength for Men. Gateway 2000 Direct Personal Computers. And at First Plus, we're working first for you.
This is why Clemson has a chance to win. Duke simply botches the inbounds pass. Wojo fumbles it, and it's out of bounds. Now 9.6, and remember, the last time Clemson had a timeout and took the ball out of bounds, they hit a layup. 9.6 to go. They're going to put the ball in Buckner's hands out of bounds, and here is McIntyre. Wojo's on him.
He's a clutch player. He beat Maryland at
McIntyre
the end of the
game. Going again. Here's the pull-up short. Battle loose.
Oh, oh,
into the game. With two looks, and they can't put it down. They had two golden opportunities, but failed both times. And believe me, Duke didn't win. They survived in here this afternoon.
They were lucky to win this one, Red. They were right there. They had the chance at the end, Clemson. They got the shot they wanted out of McIntyre, who's been a clutch player in his career. A gallant effort by the kids of Clemson.
Here, let's take a look at this now. You'll see the open shot, the first one. There's McIntyre. He's short off the iron. Now watch Iturbe. He comes up firing. He, too, is short on the iron. And you can see the red light. The game is over as it was ricocheting off the iron. A first look. Wojo does a great job defensively. Comes over and gets a hand across his eye. Now watch Iturbe. Pull it up and fire. Game over.
But I'll tell you, they got the shot they wanted out of McIntyre. Mike Krzyzewski and his staff knows they're a little bit lucky to hold on and get this W.
Dick, are you going to vote for Duke number one in the AP poll?
Yes, Duke number one, North Carolina number two. No doubt about it. They're on a run right now. They survive and beat a quality team.
Of all the crazies, you're the best. All right, Dick. That wraps it up here. John Saunders, a lot of excitement. 81-80.
Wow.
Duke hangs on to beat Clemson. John Saunders is coming your way next on ABC.